My dad was like the best storyteller. I mean, he is the best storyteller. He's just one of those people when, like, you know, you're at a dinner party or something, he starts talking and everybody is just like eyes glued on him. And he tells the same stories over and over. Like, he tells the same stories again, but they're just so captivating. I mean, I think part of it is the circumstances. Like, he came to the US when he was 19. So super young, and this was in, you know, the beginning of the 70s. So the world was just so different then. So he just paints this picture of what America was like, the difference between America and Thailand. So he talks about how, you know, him and his brother, they got on the plane in Thailand at the went to the airport dressed in suits, like they look like the Beatles, you know, like a real slim dark suit with a tie, like your but you wore your best clothes to get on the airplane. It was a huge deal to be able to come to America. And their parents saw them off, and you know, they and of course it just took at that time like 48 hours to get here. They had to fly to Japan and Hawaii and you know, connect in all these places. And he said that they landed in Los Angeles in like 1969, 1970. And the friend that had been living in the US for a while came to pick them up at the airport. And he was wearing bell-bottom jeans and like a hippie shirt that was unbuttoned all the way, like bare chest and like long hair, and was like, you know, "Hey man, welcome to America." And my dad was like, "Okay, I never put that suit on again." Like he just instantly became an American kid, like American hippie after that. That's one of my favorite stories.
For more author interviews, please visit readingrockets.org.